So are they all three pieces were recordings you had to eavesdrop?
Yeah, or manipulated, yeah. Existing recordings that got changed and adjusted. Which is, you know, this is a piano roll. It's meant for playing back things that already exist.
But what controls the duration?
The duration is just how long you hold on to it.
But would the whole tune play if you stayed there for an hour?
Yeah, so it's not a 4-minute clip of Rites of Spring.
I see.
But you can hear some of the tonality of the Rites of Spring, and I'm not sure. It's from the very beginning. And you can just sit here and play it. I might have put in a safety catch to make it stop at some point in case there was a bridge or like an EM signal that was messing it up.
So it's 4 minutes, so if you press for 6 minutes, it would just loop?
Yep. It might stop just because of that. I think right there is where it stops because I put a catch in there
so you're just accessing something that's already running, you just kind of tap into it later.
Exactly. You're accessing, it exists in here. And then it just comes into existence, manifest based on your interaction.
And your effort touching it also has an effect, or?
What's that?
Your effort?
Right. Your effort, yeah. So me and Carol were looking at this, and it turns out we kind of decided some people are maybe more conductive than other people.
Yeah.
Some people, I'm used to it, so, you know, but I think, you know, if you're not familiar with it.
Conductor.
She's completely
there, yeah. But everybody has their own conductance, so that's another part of it too. It's unique to everybody. And
here's my copper jewelry for those who are not very conductive. It's copper pipe over here.
You can also do it with multiple people. So for example, if I'm holding here, does someone mind?
Oh, we need a participant from the audience.
So hold here. Nothing's happening, right?
Oh,
but if I touch her hand,
oh,